Welcome back to the Vern stage. On behalf of the California Bluegrass Association, Vern stage, we've got a great afternoon of music. You've already heard some wonderful acts. We're not going to be done. We're going to hear the corn liquors at 5:45 and 6:30, Crying Uncle Bluegrass Band. But now, an act I originally thought was going to be a legal seminar, to sound like my local law firm, Wilhoyte and Sauber. LLC.
Atomic power, will you rise and meet your savior in the air? Will you shout or will you cry when the fire rains from on high? Are you ready for the great atomic power? Do you fear this man's invention that they call atomic power? Are we all in great confusion? Do you know the time or hour when the terrible explosion may rain down upon our land, leaving horrible destruction, blotting out the works of man? Are you ready for the great atomic power? Will you rise and meet your savior in the air? Will you shout or will you cry when the fire rains from on high? Are you ready for the great atomic power? Jesus, he will be your shield and sword. He will surely stand beside you, and you'll never taste of death, for your soul will fly to safety and eternal peace and rest. Are you ready for the great atomic power? Will you rise and meet your savior in the air? Will you shout or will you cry when the fire rains from on high? Are you ready for the great atomic power? It's a regiment of Christians guided by the Savior's hand. When the mushrooms of destruction fall in on their fury great, God will surely save his children from that awful, awful fate. Are you ready for the great atomic power? Will you rise and meet your Savior in the air? Will you shout or will you cry when the fire rains from on high? Are you ready for the great atomic power? Will you shout?
Thank you.
I get the nervous energy out.
Leave me here alone. making me think of home.
Seen the soup by the times we're living in today, and that one was written by the Delmore brothers. It was actually written for Jimmy Rogers, who didn't get a chance to record it due to his untimely death.
But it's in the way every time.
It's been recorded by many folks, including Doc Watson and of course Tony Rice, and probably not by us. Unless you're recording it right now. All right.
That's right.
All right, now we're gonna put it up in B. We're doing oldie but a goodie. For all you following along, this is a B. Anyone's got a dobro, leave it in the case.
Let's try not to alienate everybody right off the bat. Give us a couple songs.
Sorry,
we'll get there.
Sometimes politically incorrect. Yeah, my wife's always on me about that.
Anti-dobro.
All right, here we go. Dark Hollow. I'd rather be in some dark hollow where the sun don't ever shine. In a small room with grub on the mind. But blow your whistle, freight train, and be far thrown down the track. I'm going away, I'm leaving today. I'm going, but ain't coming back. Knowing that you're gone. they ain't coming back.
We know you've never heard that one before, so glad to introduce that number to you.
Larry Sparks did not ever record that one. Now we're going to turn Patrick loose on something. Actually, this
and
is
Mike.
Yeah, I mean, well, this is co-written by Bill Monroe and Doc Watson. I keep bending that second string out of the tune. Sorry.
Because you care.
That's close enough. Okay. Watson Blues. Patrick on this one again.
And Mike, there's only two of us, so it's hard to get too far away from anything.
I don't like to say I'm going to feature myself on this song.
We're going to feature Mike on this number.
All right.
That's Mike Wilhoyte over there. I don't know if we introduced ourselves.
Thank you. Also known as Christine Wilhoyte's dad. She's got more name recognition than I do at this point. I was just telling her that the other day. I was like, that's really funny to me. It was Wilhoyte and Sauber. And what do you say? Wilhoyte the Sober? No.
Not if we can help it.
And anywho, so someone asked my daughter, Christine, who's been running around here with the banjo doing all kinds of stuff, if she's playing. She said, no, that's my dad. Who's that? Anyway, all right.
Yeah, if anyone showed up, they just found out. So I suppose it's Bill Monroe time on the old napkin set list.
Mighty dark to travel. It's mighty dark for me to travel, oh, for my sweetheart she is gone. Road is rough, filled with gravel, I must journey on and on. Above. On the day that I first met her was when I told her of my love. It's mighty dark for me to travel, for my sweet heart she's gone. Oh, it's rough, filled with gravel, I must journey on and on.
Mystery guest up now.
Yeah.
Tom Sauber, everybody.
Yeah.
Mystery guest.
Man of mystery.
The man of mystery.
Yes, contain your enthusiasm, please.
As I always like to say, keep your expectations low.
We'll meet them every time. For our next number, we're going to do a tune that some of you might know, but it was written by a very close friend of ours, a fellow by the name of Bill Bryson. Anyone ever heard of Bill Bryson? Anyone remembers Bill? Wonderful singer, songwriter, bass player. Yeah, we lost Bill in 2017, but so we try to talk about him as much as we can, play his songs, and remind everybody that Larry Sparks did not write this song. It had nothing to do with it whatsoever. Called Girl at the Crossroads Bar.
All right.
Walked out one night for to ramble around. Didn't mean to stay just to view the town. When I saw her smiling from afar, and she walked into that crossroads bar. Inside and set me down, ordered three red wine make it down. She came and sat beside me there with dark brown eyes and a red, red hair.
Again, here's another one you might recognize, but like I said, Bill is a, in addition to playing a lot of bluegrass, he loved old-time music, and has anyone heard of the Bluegrass Cardinals?
Yeah.
Bill is an original member of the Bluegrass Cardinals, and he brought this number. This is a very old song, goes back probably to just after the Civil War, and he brought this song to the Cardinals, but he changed it from a waltz into 2/4, and we're going to put it right back as a waltz. Yeah, Bill can't have anything to say about it now. So the original name is, it's called Two Soldiers, but you might know it as Blue-Eyed Boston Boy. All right, let's give it a shot. Here we go.
Good enough.
Yeah, one, two, three, one.
He was just a blue-eyed Boston boy. His voice was low with pain. I'll do your bidding, comrade mine, if you will do the same. But if you ride on and I should fall, you'll do as much for me. Why, mother at home is awaiting her sons, so write to her tenderly. She's waiting at home like a patient saint, her pale face filled with woe. Her heart will be broken when I am dead, I'll see her face no more. There stand the order came to charge, for moment hand touched hands. They answered aye, and on they rode, that brave and devoted band. Thank you. held. Out furrows of death in the toiling ranks, and guarded them as they fell. There soon came a horrible dying sound from the heights they could not gain. And those that doom and death had spared rode slowly back again. And among the dead at the top of the hill lay the boy with the golden hair. And the tall dark man who rode by his side lay still beside him there. There was none to write to his blue-eyed girl the words her lover had said. While mother at home is awaiting her son, she'll only find he's dead. While mother at home is awaiting her son, she'll only find he's dead.
Again.
Little girl and the dreadful snake.
No requests.
Security.
Please write all requests on the back of a $100 bill.
Oh, yeah. Right away.
Sure.
Good thing I got this napkin. Oh, I got the same.
Only the finest sets are written on napkins. Let's need to remind everyone of that.
So this is a... Who wrote this? Was this Utah Phillips?
Gordon Lightfoot.
Gordon Lightfoot. Oh, wow.
Who we just
showing how much I know about that kind of music.
One of the all-time great singer-songwriters.
Yes, buddy. When am I done? Are you just over here? Oh, yeah. He's asking when I'm going to be done.
When's lunch?
This is Ryan, my son, Ryan. He's going to start kindergarten in the fall. Maybe another 10 minutes, bud. Why? You got to go potty? Oh, no.
He's not the only one.
Wait, what are we doing again? I forgot.
We've gone off the rail slightly. That's all right.
Oh, yeah. Road ahead. There we go. Sorry, I just went in the dad mode there for a second.
He broke the fourth wall. That's all right. That's right. It is potty.
Thank you. not change for any man. I tried to comfort her, but she would not be still. Out of the rain to fall, as I found my way back down the Redwood Hill, I'll not forget the day when Mother Nature cried on the Redwood Hill.
That 10 more songs or 10 more minutes? I forgot. Oh. All right. Oh. Boop, boop, boop. All right. We're gonna. Oh, if we got 10 more minutes, we'll do another couple. Okay. We're gonna put up. Hey, buddy. You got to be a little patient here, bud.
We had to call an audible there with all this time left.
So here's one that Mac Wiseman did, but according to this guy here, the Carter family did it, and they went back to the one chord on a certain part. So
you'll just have to guess where.
I'll just have to guess where. But
the hard part about having a historian nearby.
Which is a good thing. But here we go. This is the Mac Wiseman version of I Wonder How the Old Folks. Folks, not farts. I wonder how the old folks are at home.
Well, I wonder how the old folks are at home. I wonder if they'll miss me while I'm gone. I wonder if they'll pray for the boy who went away and left his dear old parents all alone. You could hear the cattle lowing in the lane. You could almost see the fields of bluegrass green. You could almost hear them cry as they kiss your boy goodbye. I wonder how the old folks are home. Shield you from all harm. A mother's love so true, a sweetheart there for you. A village and a homestead on the farm. You could hear the cattle lowing in the lane. You could almost see the fields of the grass green. You could almost hear them cry as they kiss your boy goodbye. I wonder how the old folks are at.
They're fine. Yeah. All right, here we go. Here's a
foster. That's nice.
I was in the wrong gear. Yep. Well, that's embarrassing.
You better get right.
You ever join the jam and put it in the wrong place and you go, what's wrong with everybody? Oh, it's me.
Well, we're about to break one of the cardinal rules of bluegrass folks of our generation.
We're gonna put this on.
And the rule to never play this next song. But we're going to do it a little different, so pay attention, see if you can notice the difference. All right. We don't need to introduce it. It'll make itself really apparent very quickly.
She walks through the woods down to the river, her hair shone like gold in the hot morning sun. She took
the reason for the fall. When woman tempted man down in paradise's hall, when woman tempted me and took me for a ride, and like the weary fox, I need a place to hide. She walks through the corn leading down to the river. Her hair shone like gold in the hot morning sun. She took all the love that a poor boy could give her and left me to die like a fox on the run. Like a fox,
like a fox.
So we'll make it quick.
Darling, walk me far away.
Little Stanley Brothers time with no banjo.
Time for a beer.
Time for a beer, all right.